We need them. Yes, we do. We need those strategies. Those strategies for living, that is. So are you ready? You ready for your daily dose of radio rehab?
It's just good for you.
It is good for you. It is. There's no question about it. Hey, folks, welcome. Welcome into 101.7 FM. 710 Keel. Welcome into another edition of Strategies for Living. I'm Dr. David McMillan. He's Jimmy Bryant, PhD. That means he produces, he hosts, and he directs. And she's PLPC Lauren Leon McMillan.
Yes, hello.
Yeah, neither one of y'all are old enough to remember the guy that said, I got a million of them. Yeah, neither one of you know who that is, do you?
I know the phrase.
You know the phrase?
Totally yeah. Familiar with all, yeah, with that, yeah. But I don't know who it is. Yeah.
Jimmy Durante.
Okay.
Yeah. Jimmy Durante, he when I was coming up, he was older, but he'd be on the variety shows. He would appear on Red Skelton and
Ed Sullivan.
And necessarily Ed Sullivan as much, but he'd be on the shows like Red Skelton and Danny Kaye, anybody that had a variety show, Burnett, that type of thing. You know, and I thought of that when you think about quotes,
yeah,
there are millions out there. I got a million of them.
Oh, gotcha. Okay, I see the connection now.
And there's some quotes that you are inspired by. There's some quotes that motivate you, right? Mm-hmm. There's some quotes that are funny. Some make you chuckle. Some are spiritual. Mm-hmm. Some talk about the trials and tribulations of life, and some, you know, go straight to the heart. Well, when you look at quotes from Carl Jung, I think you could get all of those.
Yeah.
Because good quotes will leave an imprint on anybody that comes upon them, reads them, or hears them, and they'll even shed some light.
That was one of my favorite things that we did in class.
Yeah.
Growing up was we had a journal.
Yeah.
And my teacher, Ms. Vogler, would often write a quote on the board.
Oh,
and that was our.
And you had a journal.
We had, yeah.
That's neat.
Yeah.
That's neat. So I thought we would check out some Carl Jung quotes this evening. I've got a bunch of them, so we won't get to all of them this evening, but maybe we can get a start. And, Carl Jung was legend. He was a Swiss psychiatrist. He was the founder of analytical psychology. Mm-hmm. He was a contemporary of Sigmund Freud. But his analytical psychology was a holistic approach that, you know, Freud focused on the body and mind.
But he also roped in the spirit.
Yeah. Carl Jung was body, mind, and soul and the human psyche. And so we're going to explore Carl Jung through some of his words this evening. How about that?
That sounds great.
Right here on Strategies for Living. Folks, we appreciate you tuning in. We appreciate you joining us. And we appreciate our sponsors making it possible. The Robinson Film Center and Azalea Cleaners and Pintail Roofing.
Roof, roof.
And Learning RX and Hempress Cannabis with Love and the Shreveport Little Theater. We are going to talk Carl Jung on life and wisdom and perspective this evening here on Strategies for Living. Lots to learn. Stay with us.
Hi, this is Jay Merle for Pintail Roofing. Let's talk about quality. When you hire Pintail to build your roof, here's what you can expect. Quality and quality control are the most important concerns for us at Pintail, and you need to know that Pintail stands tall with swift and professional performance on any warranty call. This is our most important policy. And remember, we're your neighbors. We'll be here for you for the long haul. Our family's lived here for over 100 years, and we aren't going anywhere. On the commercial side of Pintail's business, our fluid-applied roofing solutions can save thousands of dollars over conventional commercial roofing options. Call Pintail at 226-ROOF for a free inspection of your home or commercial building. That's 226-7663. Pintail Roofing. What's the condition of your roof?
And welcome in. Welcome into 101.7 FM, 710 Keel. Welcome into Strategies for Living. Lauren Leon McMillan and Jimmy Bryant, David McMillan. You guys can thank me later.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'll thank you
now. No, well, okay, because I'm about to give you a handful of wonderful Instagram captions, so you can thank me later.
Oh, okay.
I mean, really. I mean, Carl Jung, you know, he was profound. Mm-hmm. He was sometimes poetic. Mm-hmm. And his words cover such a variety of topics and give insight into that, the hard and the mundane and the wonderful moments.
Well, and that's
we all encounter.
Part of the reason why I say that I got into psychology and counseling. I mean, because it's so, I mean, it's pervasive. You can apply it to everything.
Yeah.
All of life.
And Carl Jung's words and what he left us give us, really a commentary on our journey through life. Mm-hmm. You know, they're not just good to turn to when you're seeking an answer to something, but they make you think. Mm-hmm. They stretch your mind, and that's why I said they even make great Instagram captions. And you know, a lot of people. What else they do is they make great affirmations.
Oh,
they
yeah.
make great daily affirmations. So. You guys can thank me later for this. Yeah. Okay, so let's dive in. You are what you are, what you do, not what you say you'll do. That's a good one to start out with.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It reminds me of your Aunt Brill, to be honest.
My Aunt Ruth?
Your Aunt Ruth.
Why do you say? Oh.
Because you always told her that you would go.
Yeah. I mean, I love my Aunt Ruth. I really did. My father's sister. And she was a hoot. She really was. If you knew my Aunt Ruth, if you ever went to a reception back in the day at St. John's Church, St. John's Catholic Church, later St. John, now St. John Berkman's Cathedral. Aunt Ruth, if there was a luncheon to be had, if there was an event, well, Aunt Ruth was in charge of it.
Right.
She, from making the little sandwiches to the fruit punch and whatever else was going to be served. I mean, Aunt Ruth was front and center. My favorite Aunt Ruth story was. There was a reception one day, and it seemed like the multi-room was packed. The bishop was there,
right?
And I went into the multi-room, and I'm in the back of it. Aunt Ruth is up towards the stage, but she saw me come in, and at the top of her voice, when I walked in the door, she said, "Liar!"
All eyes are on you, including
the bishops are on me, and I'm just those moments that feel like they are
they last forever.
Yeah,
sure. Yeah,
they it just
time
like,
kind of stops. It slows down. Yeah,
really. And so, but what my Aunt Ruth would always every time we would encounter each other. I'd say, I'm coming to see you.
Right.
You know? And she'd say, I'm holding you to that. So when I'd see her the next time mm-hmm. and I hadn't come to see her, she'd always lovingly say, you're a liar.
So, yeah, you are what you do, not what you say you'll do.
Absolutely. Right?
I would like to tack on to that, though. You know, it's not what you do, but then how you do it.
Mm.
That's truly to me. Who you are.
Yeah. It's not just what you do.
No.
It's how you do it.
Yeah.
You know, I'd argue it doesn't really matter what you do.
It's how you do
it.
It's the intent. Anything done in love and with love.
Right.
And kindness.
Which is interesting because, this quote, it's not what you do. You're what is it? You are not what
you're not
do.
What you do. You are what you do, not what you say you'll do.
So the say you, what you say you'll do is what most people call intention.
Yeah.
But that's not true intention.
Yeah.
Right? That's just what you say.
Yeah.
True intention is the how
it's
you
the
do
follow,
it.
It's the follow through and the how to, how you do
it. Is the yeah. how you do it. Yeah.
Here's another one. Who looks outside dreams? Who looks inside awakes. That is so powerful.
Yes, it is. And yeah. if we can truly take that one and run with it.
Yeah. The kingdom of God is within you.
Right.
Hmm. Wow.
You know, and if we're considering everything that's outside, even if you don't believe that it's a dream, right?
Right.
You can't control what's outside.
Right.
You can control what's inside.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. To ask the right question is already half the solution of a problem.
Mm-hmm.
To ask the right question is already half the solution of a problem.
The answer's in the problem.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. And but we got to be willing to question.
Yep.
You know, and how many times do we say on this program, let's question, I mean, why wouldn't we question everything?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, why wouldn't we? Because that's keeping our minds open, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. Let's question everything. So to ask the right question is already half the solution to the problem.
Well, and just for any of my young test takers out there, you can apply that in class. The answers are in the questions.
Mm. Yeah.
Just slow
yeah.
down.
Yeah, slow
All
down
you gotta
and
do
read.
Is slow down.
Yep. Yep.
Point.
Yeah, that's a great point, Jimmy. Everyone you meet knows something you don't know, but need to know. Learn from them. Oh.
Yeah, I love this one. And I, you know, this is one, not necessarily this particular quote, but the idea behind it is something I really, truly try to practice and implement every day.
Yeah.
Especially in, you know, in the work I do as a counselor, right? Coming in, yeah, I've got a lot of knowledge, and the person is coming to me, you know, quote unquote, often they think for advice, but
right.
that's not how it works, right?
No, no.
But more often than not, the healing goes both ways.
Absolutely.
Right?
Yeah.
And it's about, and it, you don't have to be, it,
that
whatever,
room,
it doesn't matter.
That room is a room of healing.
It
that
is.
Room is where healing takes place. And sometimes the client's the one that gets healed.
Right, sometimes.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, it doesn't have to be a counseling room. I mean, if you take this truly wherever you go, I mean, it reminds me of A Course in Miracles, which is that, a quote from A Course in Miracles, that, you know, everything is the echo of God.
Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
If you're listening.
Yep.
If you, and it doesn't have to be just hearing, listening. You have to have your eyes open. You have to have your ears open.
Yeah, we can listen with every sense.
Yes.
Your heart open, all
right.
of it. Yeah,
right.
all of it.
And if you are able to approach life that way, knowing that that stranger on the street who approached you for quote-unquote no reason, right, there is a reason, right?
Yeah.
And they have something for you.
Until you make the unconscious conscious, it will direct your life. And you will call it fate.
Can we put a pin in there for 1 second? Just one last thing on the other one.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
For all of my managers out there,
mm-hmm.
Having that attitude makes you so much more formidable. And not in the context of being against people, but
right.
just in our competitive society that we live in, being able to identify, being able to acknowledge that everyone has value.
Absolutely.
And taking the time to identify it, just it makes you better at whatever you do.
We can learn from babies. We can learn from 3-year-olds. We can learn from first graders.
Yes, as someone who nannied 7 girls for 7 years.
Yeah.
Yes.
You
they
learned
They were
a
my
ton.
Biggest teachers.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Okay, until you make the unconscious conscious, it will direct your life, and you will call that fate.
Yep.
This one is so very pertinent and important for us today, because I think a lot of us live so
unconsciously, yeah, so reactively.
Yeah. We don't live in the moment. We don't live in the present. We live unconsciously, as you say.
Yeah.
And the work of our lives is to unpack the tremendous unconscious mind, the powerful. It's all there.
It is. Everything.
It's all there. The universe is within you, all of us. And the wisdom of the universe is, whether you're 1 year old or whether you're 101 years old, it's there.
Yep.
And, you know, as we grow, our jobs, one of our main jobs is to plumb the unconscious, because the more we are able to plumb that unconscious mind, and we can do that in a lot of ways. We can do that by paying attention to our dreams.
Mm-hmm.
We can do that by tuning into our Freudian slips.
Right.
We can do it by just our imaginative life, our dreamy imaginative life, our daydreaming, if you will. And
by questioning.
And by questioning, by paying attention to it, by tuning into it, and then by questioning it.
Yeah.
What did that mean?
Where did I get that?
Yeah. Where did that come from? Where did I learn to feel that? Yeah.
Way, or to think that way.
So there's a lot of ways to unpack and make the conscious mind, make the unconscious mind conscious, if you will. Mm-hmm. But most of us don't do that.
No.
And, you know, I think Jung was right on target.
They continue to call it fate. I can't help it.
It'll direct our lives, and we'll call it fate. Yeah. And
that's just who I am. Well, that's who you're allowing and choosing yourself to be.
Normality is a fine ideal for those who have no imagination. I love this. Yeah.
Yes.
If you're gonna use your imagination, if you're gonna use your creativity, I guarantee you there will be some people who will call you crazy.
Yeah.
Who will think you're off your rocker.
Absolutely.
Who would wonder what in the world has got into you? Why are you going to go do that?
Well, and that's part of the beauty of the spectrum of perspective.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And that's why you're here, I'd argue. You know, why are you going to do that? Because I'm the only one who would think to do that.
There you go.
And would enjoy it and bring it into the world.
And even those who would say you're crazy or it's not their cup of tea, it still challenges them. They still have to chew on it.
Right.
Yep.
And I mean, how many great artists, great thinkers, right? Can we go back in time and look at how they were called mad, right?
Yeah.
I think that's 100%. I don't think that there was one that was not called mad.
Yeah.
And yet we look back on them today and are grateful for their contributions to the world.
And absolutely grateful and appreciative of their fortitude.
Mm. Yep.
And that they stayed the course and hung in there.
Yep. 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 In spite of what other people said. Mm-hmm. We're turning to Carl Jung this evening on life, on wisdom, and on perspective. Talking about it today here on Strategies. We've got more of the wisdom of Carl Jung to share with you this evening on Strategies for Living. So don't go away. You know, it's been going on for 101 years now. I'm talking about the Shreveport Little Theater. Been enriching our lives through the performing arts and education and opportunities to volunteer service guided by professional artists. They've been at it a long time. And up next, beautiful, the Carol King musical is the summer musical this year. And have you seen the 24-25 season? My goodness. Neil Simon's Brighton Beach memoirs, Steel Magnolias, It's a Wonderful Life, Doubt, I Love You, You're Perfect, Now Change, and then May We All, a new country musical. You know, you need to get your season tickets right now. ShreveportLittleTheater.com. It is American theater at its best at 812 Margaret Place in Shreveport. Shreveport Little Theater. ShreveportLittleTheater.com. And welcome back into Strategies for Living here on 101.7 FM, 710 Keel. Jimmy Bryant and Lauren Leon McMillan, David McMillan with you. We are talking the life, the wisdom, and perspective that we can squeeze out of the words of Carl Jung.
I'm going to have to get my pipe out.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. I love this one. I love this next one. The privilege of a lifetime.
Yeah, this is a good one.
Is to become who you truly are.
That's it. Done. Yeah, deal.
Let me read that again. The privilege of a lifetime is to become who you truly are.
Isn't that
so
beautiful?
Profound.
It is. And no matter what you, if you believe in reincarnation or you don't, it doesn't matter what you believe in terms of that. You will never, your soul will not be in this particular body, in this particular form ever again.
Yeah.
I mean, so...
You got one go-round in this particular way, even if you believe we come back.
Right.
Some people do.
Right.
In fact, most of the world does.
Actually.
Most of the world believes in the concept of reincarnation. I can't prove it or disprove it, so, you know, I'll just nod to it. You know, and say, okay, well, a lot of people believe that.
Well, it makes sense to me in terms of energy is never, it's not created nor destroyed.
Yeah.
It's only transformed.
Yeah.
So, you know, where it goes beyond that.
Who knows? But you've got this chance, this lifetime, this chance to be who you truly are. Mm-hmm. And it's the privilege of a lifetime. I love that.
And so why give that power away ever?
Yeah.
You know,
to anyone, anytime, any
anything.
Place. Yeah. Yep.
For any reason. There is no reason.
The ability to ask questions is the greatest resource in learning the truth.
Yeah. I mean, how many times do we talk about the questions, right?
Yeah.
And it's really way far less. I mean, he kind of hinted at this at the earlier quote. It's so much less about the answers because we'll never truly know a lot of answers, right?
Yeah, but we're supposed to ask the questions, and there's so many there's so many areas in our world, in our society, in our culture. I mean, there are religions that you dare not question, right? There are political parties that you dare not question, and one or the other, and that's part of the issue. There are countries, there are ideals and ideas that you dare not question.
And yet, this is one of the freest times I think we've had.
Yeah.
In terms of having the freedom to question.
I definitely agree with that, and I think that what we're seeing in terms of the tension, the conflict, is the birthing. Is the birthing of something new. Now, there's going to probably continue to be some discomfort as we move through this.
Well, and here I liken the collective that we're going through in terms of it's the same as what an individual goes through in counseling or in their process of becoming.
Yeah.
It's that the unconscious is being made conscious.
Yeah. And you're asking questions about all the things that
and it gets ugly.
You thought you believed and you thought you knew and you thought this is truth. But you ask the questions and you find out it's a house of cards.
It starts to crumble. And that's what we're seeing and that's what we're being a part of.
Yeah.
And I might ask you, you know, are you in the back end, helping to create the new, what you want to see in the world.
Yeah.
And a reminder that destruction is loud.
Yeah.
Creation is quiet.
Very quiet.
Yeah.
The difference between a good life and a bad life is how well you walk through the fire. Now, that's so important because good life, bad life, according to Jung, you're going through the fire.
Sure.
And that's true.
Mm-hmm.
It's very true. It's the difference between a good life and a bad life is how well you walk through the fire.
It's that resilience, the being able to forge ahead, another fire word there,
Wholeness is not achieved by cutting off a portion of one's being, but by integration of the contraries. Mm. Ooh. You know, we talk, there so many of these hit some of the things, a lot of the things that we talk about a lot here on Strategies. Mm-hmm. And some of what we talk about is that all of us are made of different parts.
Mm-hmm. And there are no bad parts.
And there are no bad parts. And that, you know, wholeness is achieved, is not achieved by cutting off a portion of one's being. All of those different parts are part of your being.
Right.
You know? Some of them you may not really want to embrace, but we need to embrace all of our parts, because that integration of contraries is what makes us.
Absolutely. I mean, it kind of goes back to the spiritual Tao, right?
Yeah.
Which is the yin yang.
Yeah.
Right? It's the being able to recognize that, you know, you wouldn't in a room full of light and sun, you wouldn't know anything different, right?
Yeah.
And whereas if you're in the dark and there's a candle lit,
you see the
you
light.
Have to be thankful for the darkness, otherwise you couldn't see the candle.
Yeah.
That's right.
Right.
Yeah.
The highest, most decisive experience is to be alone with one's own self. You must be alone to find out what supports you. When you find that, you cannot support yourself. Only this experience can give you an indestructible foundation. The highest, most decisive experience is to be alone with one's own self.
Okay. Yes.
You must be alone to find out what supports you. When you find that, you cannot support yourself. Only this experience can give you an indestructible foundation.
Hmm. You must be alone to find out what supports you. Hmm. When you find that you cannot support yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, again, it points back to me that
the wholeness is inside.
Yeah, that points back to several of the other quotes, including the wholeness is inside. It's all inside of you.
Right.
But it also for me goes back to we've got to plumb the unconscious, because that's where a lot of it is. So we've got to make that unconscious conscious,
right?
So that we can use it.
And the deal is, you know, you're with you all the time, your entire life.
Yep.
The longest relationship you'll ever be in
is
the one with yourself.
Yep.
At least in this lifetime.
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
And so, you know, especially in this day of, oh my gosh, constant distraction and rush and hurry and all the things
and
to
conflict
do,
and everything else. Yeah.
It takes us so much outside of ourselves and makes it even more important that we take time to be with ourselves.
Yeah.
And the other thing, read that first part of it again, the highest.
The highest, most decisive experience is to be alone
with one's own self. And the other thing I like is the word alone.
Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
Because if you add an extra L, suddenly it becomes all one.
Oh, I love it.
Right.
I love it.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that's where he's going. It is all one in you.
Yeah.
You must be alone to find out what supports you when you find that you cannot support yourself. Mm-hmm. And we all have that.
Yeah.
I mean, we lie. Again, that's part of going through the fire, isn't it? That's part of what that means.
The thing, one of the most important lessons I've learned from being alone is that I'm never alone.
Yeah. Yeah. We are not what happened to us. We are what we wish to become.
Mm.
Mm. That's, you know, that is so hopeful because we're always, it doesn't matter what's happened, we're always
becoming. Right.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's up to you. It's your choice as to what you continue to bring into the present moment.
Right.
Each present now moment is brand new.
Absolutely.
That's actually how time works.
Yeah.
And we've, you know, we've created this bag of things to carry around with us from the past that we don't have to. Mm.
I love this next one. Let's just let this sink in.
Okay.
Okay, this is, just hear this with as an open mind as you can. Thinking is difficult. That's why most people judge. We live in a world that is full. It's full of a lot of stuff, but it's full of judgment.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And thinking is difficult, and that's why most people judge. Because it helps us avoid having to think.
Right.
Yep.
I mean, because if you add any thought to anything, you can open your mind and see the other perspective. I mean, because that's what judgment is. It's the idea that, yes, I have a different perspective, and mine's better, or somehow yours is wrong.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's what judgment says.
Yeah. And this next one, I think, is very much related to thinking is difficult. That's why most people judge. The world will ask you who you are, and if you don't know, the world will tell you.
Show will.
Mm-hmm.
Show will.
Yep. And that's what happens to a lot of us. That's part of why.
And there's so much world available to us now, it's becoming kind of dangerous in that way.
Yeah.
And what I mean by that is the social media, the constant news, the constant inundation with whatever you want is there and can help form who you are.
Yep.
Yeah, and the world is going to arbitrarily tell you what you are.
Yeah.
The world is going to take this quick glance at you.
Yep.
This quick size up and you're that. And yeah, you don't want to trust that. You want to lean on that.
We're talking life and wisdom and perspective, all of that from Carl Jung this evening here on Strategies for Living. We've just barely begun. We've got more. Stay with us.
Reading begins not in the classroom, but in your child's brain. I'm Donisa Walker with LearningRx Shreveport. If your child struggles to read, maybe he or she has trouble focusing or comprehending, LearningRx Shreveport offers a science solution to reading problems, working one-on-one with your child, targeting his or her reading skills. Today, call LearningRx Shreveport. Make an appointment to have your child assessed. I know you want to help your child. So does LearningRx Shreveport.
You know, there's just no place like the Robinson Film Center, 617 Texas Street, downtown Shreveport, robinsonfilmcenter.org. There's always something going on at the Robinson. You know, the Robbies are coming up Saturday, June the 15th, and you can find out all the information on the Robbies at robinsonfilmcenter.org. And you know, summer film camps are just around the corner, too. They're in June 24th through the 28th. That's Movie Monster Camp. And then July the 8th through the 12th is Suspense Camp. You can find out all about that at robinsonfilmcenter.org. Don't forget Abby Singer's Bistro, second floor, open for lunch and dinner. Join the crowd. Join the fun. Become a member. Get discounts on movies, concession upgrades, and bistro deals at RFC, 617 Texas Street, downtown Shreveport, robinsonfilmcenter.org. And welcome back. Welcome back into 101.7 FM, 710 Keel. Welcome back into Strategies for Living as we talk life and wisdom and perspective from Carl Jung today here on Strategies for Living. Lauren Leon McMillan and Jimmy Bryant, David McMillan. As far as we can discern, the sole purpose of human existence is to kindle a light of meaning in the darkness of mere being.
Wow. That's so cool.
Say that again.
Yeah. Okay. As far as we can discern, the sole purpose of human existence is to kindle a light of meaning in the darkness of mere being.
That's so beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, because truly we come from the darkness of pure being, right? From the realm of the absolute.
Right.
Where there is no distinction between you, me, I, anything, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And so then we come into form, right? And where there really is no meaning to anything. But we get to assign that.
Yeah.
And we bring the light of our peace, of our soul, into this experience. Mm. And it's up to us to kindle that and to let that shine.
Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
For ourselves and the whole world. It harkens back to something that I've gotten over and over again from my guides.
Yep.
Which is, you know, the purpose is to accept and kindle the peace within.
Yeah, I'm reminded of what Jesus said. You know, you don't put your light under a bushel basket. You put it on a hill,
right?
So it can illuminate. Right?
Yeah, that's right.
You put it up
put
where it
up.
Can illuminate
yeah.
all.
Yeah,
right. I'm paraphrasing.
This
obviously.
Little
no,
light
but
of
that,
mine.
That, yeah, get it up. Don't put it down.
Yeah.
Put it under a bushel? No.
No, because you'd be hiding, and you know, so many of us do that.
Yeah. Well, and so many of us feel like we have to out of survival.
Yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. That we have to make ourselves small in order to, you know, be in the world.
Yeah. Do not compare. Do not measure.
Mm-hmm.
No other way is like yours. Mm-hmm. All other ways deceive and tempt you. You must fulfill the life that is in you.
Mm. It's so true. You know, I was thinking about this earlier today, actually. You know, I could compare to what other people are doing. That's about all I can do, right?
Yep.
Because I don't know what is going on in their mind. I don't know what they're thinking or what they're feeling. I could ask, and they could give me pieces of it. But
or we can assume.
Right.
And in many ways, a lot of times, that's what we do. We assume we know what somebody's thinking. I'm going to say something. We've said it before. It's harsh. But when we do that, we're mind raping.
Yep.
Unless somebody tells you definitively what they're feeling and thinking, mm-hmm. you don't know.
No, you don't. And you're raping.
Yeah.
But even then, even if they do tell you what they're feeling and thinking, first you have to trust that they're honest with themselves and honest with you, right?
Right.
First you have to trust that.
Which I think are two different things.
They are.
Absolutely. two compounding things. And then even beyond that, I don't know what the whole experience is.
Right.
So any kind of comparison that I can do to really, in actuality, just what I'm seeing behavior-wise is meaningless.
And I can be sure mm-hmm. that even if you're being honest with yourself mm-hmm. and being honest with me, it's only to the best of your ability because you didn't see everything.
Right.
So you, I know you don't know everything.
Right. That's right.
And you guys are unpacking why you know, judgment doesn't make sense.
No.
Why comparison doesn't make sense.
No, because in so many cases, we never know the full story of what it took for that person to get there.
Right.
Because we don't know their...
We can't possibly.
We don't know their lived experience. I mean, they could tell us, but again, we didn't live the experience.
Yeah, and they may not even have done their work yet.
Right.
Yeah.
And so, again, that goes back to how honest can I be with myself and with others about the experience.
Yeah.
And so it's just all a huge guessing game.
Yeah.
And so what can I control in that situation but my own experience then?
Free will is the ability to do gladly that which I must do. Yeah. Free will is the ability to do gladly that which I must do. You know, because again, if we're really living the full life,
yeah,
we're going to express and live what is coming from deep within us.
Yeah. And anything, everything that comes to you in life, every person, every event, every situation, every place that comes to you, you know, is for you.
Yep.
And that, to me, that quote speaks to that. You know, you can't really, once you master a certain level, I think maybe you can control what comes to a degree.
Yeah.
but the thing that you can always have control over is your response. How are you, what meaning are you assigning to it? What are you taking from it?
Yep. We're about out of time, so okay. I'm gonna you know, Jung talked a lot about synchronicity.
Mm.
So I'm gonna end with this quote. Synchronicity is an ever-present reality for those who have eyes to see.
That's right. Yep.
Synchronicity is an ever-present reality for those who have eyes to see. Wisdom and perspective on life from Carl Jung. We're unpacking a lot today. Here on Strategies for Living, and we'll do this again because we've got a whole lot more. We've got a whole lot more of the words of wisdom of Carl Jung. We've just barely scratched the surface this evening, but I'm glad we did. We'll be back. You're gonna see the difference when you go to Azalea Cleaners. You'll hear about it too. Azalea Cleaners has been fine dry cleaning since 1958, plus laundry, alterations and repairs, comforters, wedding gown cleaning and restoration. You'll hear about it from your friends because they'll see it too. They'll notice the Azalea difference. Azalea is convenient. 732 Azalea Drive, 9220 Ellerby Road, and 9227 Mansfield Road. Plus, the front door of your home or business with Azalea's delivery on demand. Just text SETUP to 249-8283, and Azalea will pick up your clothes and deliver them back clean and fresh to you. You can't get closer than that. That's the Azalea difference. You'll notice it right away. Others will too. The Azalea difference. Fine dry cleaning since 1958. Text SETUP to 249-8283 and get the Azalea difference. AzaleaCleaners.com. And welcome back. Welcome back into 101.7 FM, 710 Keel. Welcome back into Strategies for Living. Jimmy Bryant and Lauren Leon McMillan, David McMillan, Carl Jung. Wow. Life and wisdom, perspective. It's packed, and we just barely scratched the surface of what some of what the great gentleman had to share with us.
Forever Jung.
Yeah, yeah. Profound, poetic, you know. And they take us through life. You can't go wrong.
Yeah.
You can't go wrong with Carl Jung. The privilege of a lifetime is to become who you truly are.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Well, we'll continue, and
like
you know, we'll continue and unpack some more. There's so much that he brought to the planet, including, you know, adding the spiritual.
Absolutely, I aspire to be Jung at heart.
Yeah, I think you will always be Jung at heart.
Forever Jung?
Forever Jung. there you go. Folks, we hope you are also forever Jung.
That's right.
And we appreciate you coming and being a part of Strategies for Living. We do this for you each and every day, and we can do it because of our wonderful sponsors, the Robinson Film Center and Azalea Cleaners and Pintail Roofing.
Roof, roof.
And Learning RX and Hempress Cannabis with Love. And the Shreveport Little Theater. If today were the last day of your life, you only had one more phone call that you could make, who is it that you'd call? What is it that you'd say? And why are you waiting? Make the call. For Lauren Leon McMillan, for Jimmy Bryant, I'm David McMillan. See you next time right here on Strategies for Living.